Hey there, I'm Tom Camp, DevRel Engineer at Ably. Have you ever found yourself working in a Google Doc or some other form of collaborative project and wondered to yourself, who else is in here with me? What are they doing? That's exactly the purpose of an avatar stack. Those little circular indicators, or really any other shaped indicators, at the top of many shared documents and shared environments that let you know who's there, if they're currently active, as well as information such as where in the document they currently are. I'm going to show you how to get started with creating an avatar stack using Ably's new product, Spaces. We will be making the avatar stack update in real time to reflect who's in our webpage. We will also be digging into how to add additional information, such as, say, the color to be used for an avatar or anything else that you could imagine. So let's dive straight into the coding. Grab your favorite IDE and let's bring this avatar stack to life. If you'd rather take it at your own pace, links to the GitHub repository hosting all of this code will be in the description below. First things first, we need to set up a project and import the required libraries. Make sure you've installed the Ably Realtime and Spaces libraries. Here, we're importing Spaces from Ably Spaces library and Realtime from Ably's core library. Next, we create an Ably Realtime client. The auth URL and client ID are placeholders. Replace them with your actual authentication endpoint and client ID. If you're just needing this for a test, you can also make use of an API key directly rather than an auth URL. However, in any production environment, you should always make sure to make use of token generation for security purposes. Now we initialize the Spaces SDK using the Ably client we just created. This will enable us to interact with Ably Spaces features. Let's create a virtual space in Ably. For this demo, we're just representing a basic web page with the stack, so we will call our space demo. We're using the get method to create a new space named demo. We also set an offline timeout for 3 minutes. This means if a user is idle for 3 minutes, they will be automatically removed from the space. Now that we've created our virtual space, the next step is enter it. By entering, we'll become a member of that space and our avatar can be added to other users' stacks. Here, we're using the enter method to join the space, and we're also passing in a color attribute as part of this. This color attribute is going to be used by other clients to determine how to color this particular member who is joining this space. Lastly, let's handle scenarios where members leave the space or get removed due to inactivity. We subscribe to leave and remove events. When someone leaves, we update their avatar stack to reflect that they've left. If someone gets removed due to inactivity, we also update the avatar stack to remove them. And there you have it. You've just built a dynamic real-time avatar stack in a virtual collaborative space using Ably Spaces feature. Now it's time for the big reveal. Let's try and take this and save it. But before we do that, just to reflect what is going to change. Currently, if we open this up in a new tab, you'll see that we don't see one another being reflected in each of the browser's avatar stacks. However, if we now save this code, which updates it on the project we're doing, and go again and try and open up a new tab, suddenly we can see that they are being reflected for one another. And likewise, if we add in more and more avatars and more clients, we can see that they are actually being appropriately reflected for one another in the space. And likewise, if we start leaving, they'll be indicated as having left. After a period of time of inactivity from where the browser has been closed, they are also removed from the stack, which is the sort of feature that we intended for this But remember, avatar stacks are just the tip of the iceberg. Ably's new Spaces feature can also power things like live cursors, component locking, and even real-time emoji reactions. Combine these and you've got yourself an incredibly immersive and interactive virtual space. I hope you found this tutorial useful. This is just the start of the new Ably tutorial series going into the Spaces product and the new implementations that you can consider. For those of you looking to dive deeper, there are more details available inside of the description below. You can find documentation, more in-depth details on how Spaces works and how to use the SDK, as well as other content which pertains to how to get started with the Spaces SDK for various use cases. Thanks for watching and have a great day.